You'll have had your tea, the doings of Hamish and Dougal. Today, the Vampire of the Glen.
Hamish, Dougal, you'll have had your tea.
Well, no. Stand it.
Then you can get straight to work. You'll be digging over my allotment.
And it's the very day for it. Sunny and mild with a light breeze to lift the kilt.
Aye. It's a day with allotment written all over it.
Ah. Lead us to it.
Follow me.
Is your allotment down here?
Good Lord, no. It's down here. Here we are.
An underground allotment. That's a novelty.
Been here for years. Originally, it was an underground roof garden, but we thought that was silly, so we turned it into an allotment.
Well, it's a bit obvious, but it seems to have worked.
Well, I'll leave you to it. You'll find spades and forks over there in the potting shed, just behind the old oak tree.
The tree by the duck pond?
No, that big one across the lawn.
Oh, yes, I couldn't see it for the greenhouse.
I need you to dig out a bed for my sprouts, just here, about, 6 feet deep. Big enough to take a small, oddly shaped wardrobe. Well, better get a move on. Forecast said rain. See you later.
You're not going to leave us down here in the dark.
No, all right, I'll leave you this flaming torch and a spare bloody battery. Goodbye.
What was all that about? Hamish, are you thinking what I'm thinking?
No.
Does that coffin-shaped wardrobe remind you of anything?
Oh, yes. A coffin-shaped sideboard.
Exactly. Well, whatever it is, let's dig a grave-shaped hole for it and get out of here.
Right, and the sooner the quicker.
Digging.
Dig away. Dig.
For your life.
Here we are. A cup of tea. Am I wrong?
No, you're right. That's a cup of tea, all right.
Two lumps, Mrs. Naughtie.
It's rude to point.
Oh, sorry.
Where the devil have you been, coming home covered in dust and cobwebs?
We have been digging in the Laird's underground allotment.
Oh, I've heard tell of this. Mrs. McAllister claims he took her down there once and showed her his prize hollyhocks. She was very disappointed. She wanted to see his genitalia.
Oh, hi. Some you win and some you lose.
I tell you this, it was most disturbing. He had us digging a grave-shaped hole for a coffin-shaped wardrobe.
Jings!
You may well say jings, Mrs. Naughtie, for all the time we were digging, there were strange noises.
Well, I was very nervous.
As was I. And Hamish, did you notice that portrait?
I'll never forget it.
Good. Then you can remind me what it looked like.
An ancient picture of a man who was the very embodiment of evil. And the eyes, those eyes, they followed us round the room, out the door and all the way home.
From your description, that can only be one man. than Laird's ancient ancestor, Count Cardula the Cad.
Count Cardula, the accordion player?
Legend has it he was noted for his cruelty.
What did he do?
He played the accordion. Say he can still be heard on a winter's night when the moon is full and the tide is high and somebody puts on an accordion record.
Well, heaven knows what the Laird is up to, but one thing I do know, none of us will sleep tonight.
Oh, not again. You and your elbows.
It's Hamish. She's always grabbing the duvet.
That wasn't the duvet.
Is there no end to this torment? No. Begone. Leave me in peace. Shall I have no rest?
Will you stop hogging the duvet?
It's him. Him and his elbows.
Get some sleep. And that isn't the duvet, by the way.
And those aren't my elbows.
Oh, thank goodness. It was only a dream.
Well, now can we all get some sleep?
Good night.
Good night.
Good night
now.
Dougal.
Hamish, I didn't see you behind the cooked meat counter.
That's because I'm over here.
I just popped in for a loaf of bread.
Then it's your lucky day. Look, buy one, get one free.
Yeah, but I only need the one loaf.
Well, take the free one.
Oh, good thinking.
Any news of the Laird since he disappeared last week?
Oh, Hamish, to all intents and purposes, the Laird has vanished from the face of the earth.
Hello, you two. Oh,
the Lairdship. This is a surprise.
That's very kind of you. I'll open it later.
Well, there goes the free loaf.
Now, I feel I owe you some explanation for the events of the other evening. Well, here it is.
P.T.O. P.S.
Well, that all makes perfect sense.
We should have realized.
Everything all right now, your lairdship?
Oh, yes, the shepherd was very understanding.
Well, good, as long as you didn't have to grease his palm.
No, he seemed to be getting on quite well.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.